Possum people, and welcome back to Doki Doki Literature Club. Yeah, so it's been a while since there's been an episode. I was trying to find a good way to record, you know. So Sayori seems happy with me that I joined the literature club, and I actually still want to see her happy. So I already got a poem written down. But I am looking for the words I need to get Jimin to write the poems for Sayori. So I'm going to get the words from this poem so that Jimin could write his one down. Okay, so we're gonna write a poem for Sayori. Okay, so smile. Let's see. Sunny. Alright. Comfort. Okay. Lazy. Amazing. Special. I'm trying my best. Okay. Let's see. Treasure. Embrace. Hope. Let's see. Sunset. Bliss. Crap. Bed. Agonizing charm disoriented. Charm. Fun. Okay. Childhood. Precious. Mushroom. No. Passion. Friends. Journey. We didn't get all the words for Sayori, but I hope this is enough. Monica's here.
Hi again, Jimin. Glad to see you didn't run away on us.
Nah, don't worry. This might be a little strange for me, but I at least keep my word. Well, back at the literature club, I was the last to come in, so everyone else was already hanging out.
Thanks for keeping your promise, Jimin. I hope this isn't too overwhelming of a commitment for you. Making you dive headfirst into literature when you're not accustomed to it.
Oh, come on! Like, he deserves any slack! Yuri told me you didn't even want to join any clubs this year. And last year, too! I don't know if you plan to just come here and hang out or what. But if you don't take it seriously, then you won't see the end of it!
Natsuki, you certainly have a big mouth for someone who keeps her manga collection in the club room.
Natsuki finds herself stuck between, say, Monica and manga.
Manga is literature!
Well then. Swiftly defeated, Natsuki plops back into her seat.
Don't worry, guys. Jimin always gives it his best as long as he's having fun. He helps me with busy work without me even asking. Like cooking, cleaning my room.
How dependable.
Sayori, that's because your room is all so messy it's distracting. And you almost set your house on fire once.
Is that so?
You two are really good friends, aren't you? I might be a little jealous.
How come? You and Jimin can become good friends too?
Sayori.
Hmm?
As usual, Sayori seems oblivious to the weird situation she just put me into.
Oh, Yuri even brought you something today, you know.
Wait, Sayori!
Me?
Not really.
Don't be shy.
It's really nothing.
What is it?
Never mind. Sayori made it sound like a big deal when it's really not. What do I do?
I'm sorry, Yuri. I wasn't thinking.
I guess that means up to me to rescue the situation. Hey, don't worry about it. First of all, I wasn't expecting anything in the first place. So any nice gesture from you was a pleasant surprise. It'll make me happy no matter what.
Is that so?
Yeah, I won't make a big deal if you don't want it to be.
Alright. Well, here.
Yuri reaches into her bag and pulls out a book.
I didn't want you to feel left out. So I picked out a book that I thought you might enjoy. It's a short read, so it should keep your attention, even if you don't usually read. And we could, you know, discuss it, if you wanted.
This is... How is this girl accidentally being so cute? She even picked out a book she even thinks I'll like, despite me not reading much. Yuri, thank you. I'll definitely read this. I enthusiastically take the book.
Phew. Well, you can read it at your own pace. I look forward to hearing what you think.
Now that everyone's settled in, I expected Monika to kick off some scheduled activities for the club. That doesn't seem to be the case. Siri and Monika are having a cheery conversation in the corner. Yuri's face is already buried in a book. I can't help but notice her intense expression like she was waiting for this chance. Meanwhile, Natsuki is rummaging around in the closet.
Man, looks like no one wants to be bothered today. I slumped down in the nearest desk. How am I supposed to occupy myself with something literature related by myself like this? I guess I could always read some of the book Yuri gave me. But I'm feeling a little too tired to read. I could probably fall asleep right now. I close my eyes and end up listening in on Sayori's conversation with Monika.
We're probably gonna seem really late compared to all the other clubs, though. Well, we can't give up. The festival is our chance to show everyone what literature is all about. The problem is that the idea of a literature club sounds too dense and intellectual. But it's not like that at all, you know? We just need a way of showing that to everyone. Something that speaks to their creative minds.
That doesn't solve the problem, though.
What do you mean?
Even if we come up with the most fun thing ever, nobody will come in the first place if it's a literature event. So it's more important to figure out how to get people to show up in the first place, you know? Now that they come, we can do the thing to speak to their creative minds.
What's this? Suri is taking this really seriously.
It's rare to hear her deliberately like this.
Huh, that's a good point. In that case, do you think food will do the trick? What kind?
Well, I guess we could...
Cupcakes!
Good thinking! Natsuki would love to do that.
You're right! Natsuki makes the best cupcakes! That works out perfectly!
That wasn't why you suggested it?
Cupcakes speak to my creative tummy. Cupcakes it is then. I'm hungry.
Anyway, we still need to work out the details of the event itself. I found myself smiling. In the end, Sayori is still her usual self. But therein lies the unexpected reason I admire her. Unlike me, who has trouble finding any motivation at all, Sayori can put her mind to things and make them come to life. I suppose that's why I end up letting her get on my case about things. I can't help but wonder what it would be like to see the world through her eyes.
Oh!
I opened my eyes to find Sayori's face below my vision. I nearly fell out of my chair.
Sorry! Wait! Actually, I'm not sorry at all! It's your fault for sleeping like that! This isn't a napping club!
Does our school have a napping club?
You're staying up late again, aren't you? Now that you're at a club, you're gonna have less time for anime, you know? You need to get used to it.
Don't say that so loud. I glanced over my shoulder to see if Monika overheard.
It's true, though.
Yeah. I know. You're always looking out for me, Sayori.
It's what I do best.
That's a problem. What about you? You look out for me better than you look out for yourself. You're still oversleeping every day, aren't you?
Not every day.
That's not very convincing. How many days this past week have you gotten up on time?
It's a secret.
I knew it.
Come on! Please give me the benefit of the doubt.
I can't even do that. Look, Sayori, it's written all over you.
Huh?
Sayori glances around at herself.
How is it written all over me?
You were clearly in a rush this morning. Look, your hair is sticking out all around here. I run my fingertips down the side of Sayori's hair, trying to straighten it out. Man, you really need a brush for this.
My hair is just really hard to get right.
I won't fall for that. There's more than just your hair. Look, your bow isn't straight either. And there's toothpaste stain on your collar right here. I try to wipe off the stain with my finger.
But nobody would ever notice that.
Of course they would. Nobody's gonna tell you about it because they don't want to embarrass you. Fortunately, I really don't care about that.
Hey, yummy!
And you don't even keep your blazer buttoned up. Seriously, Sayori, why do you think you don't have a boyfriend yet?
Eh? That's super mean!
Sorry, but you'll thank me later. I start to button her blazer from the bottom. Once you see how much better it looks, you'll change your mind. Oh god.
This is so funny.
What is?
Well, I was just thinking how weird it is to have a friend who does these kinds of things.
Eh? Don't say that. You make me feel weird about it, stupid.
It's okay though. I'm happy we're like this. Aren't you?
I guess.
Hey, be careful. Button might come off.
Why is this one so hard to close? I struggle to fully close the button near her chest. Does this thing fit you properly?
It did when I brought it.
If you ever buttoned it, you would have noticed sooner that it doesn't fit you anymore. What are you smiling about?
It means my boobs got bigger again.
Are you kidding me?
Just don't say that out loud. Anyway, you look much better now, so... Why does this feel strange to see Sayori's blazer buttoned up like that?
But it's so snappy! It's not worth it at all!
Sayori hastily unbuttons her blazer once more.
Phew! That's so much better.
Sayori puts her arms out and twirls around.
So if I keep this unbuttoned, I won't get a boyfriend, right?
What kind of logic is that? And why are you saying that like it's a good thing?
Because if I had a boyfriend, then he wouldn't even let you do things like this. And you take care of me better than anyone else would anyway. So that's why I'm keeping it unbuttoned.
Stop saying all these embarrassing things.
Eh? I didn't say anything embarrassing.
Jeez. Well, anyway, just focus on trying to wake up a little earlier.
Only if you focus on going to bed earlier.
Fine, fine. It's a deal.
I guess we really are better at taking care of each other than we are taking care of ourselves.
I guess so, huh?
So maybe you should come wake me up in the morning.
You're doing it again, Sayori.
Oh, but I was joking that time.
Man, it's impossible to tell with you sometimes.
Okay, everyone.
Eh? Monica suddenly calls out.
Why don't we share the poems we wrote now? Yay! Jimin, I can't wait to read yours.
Yeah, same. I fail to sound enthusiastic, but Sayori still tries to wait to retrieve her poem.
By the way, did you remember to write a poem last night?
Yeah. My relaxation ends. I can't believe I agreed to do something so embarrassing. I couldn't really find much inspiration since I've never really done anything like this before.
Well, now that everyone's ready, why don't you find someone to share with? I can't wait!
Sayori and Monica enthusiastically pour out their poems. Sayori is on a wrinkled sheet of loose leaf torn from the spiral notebook. On the other hand, Monica wrote hers in the composition notebook. I can already see Monica's pristine handwriting from where I sit. Natsuki and Yuri reluctantly comply as well, reaching into their bags. I do the same myself. Okay, I'm gonna show my poem to Sayori first. I'm definitely most comfortable sharing it with Sayori first. She's my good friend, after all.
Oh my goodness! This is so good, Jimin!
Eh?
I love it! I didn't know Ateki was such a good writer!
Sayori, you must be seriously overreacting. I'm not a good writer at all. I honestly have no idea what I'm doing.
Well, maybe that's why. Because I have no idea what I like either.
Jeez. I'm sure Yuri's opinion has to be a little more constructive than this. Maybe even Natsuki's. Are you sure you don't like it just because I wrote it?
Eh? I'm sure that's part of it. I think I understand you better than a lot of other people, you know? So when I read your poem, it's not just a poem. It's a Jimin poem. That makes it feel really special. Like I can feel your feelings in it.
Sayori hugs the sheet against her chest. You're so weird, Sayori.
I'm really happy that you just wrote one. It just reminds me of how you're really part of the club now.
Not to mention the fact that I'm standing in front of you in the club room.
Well, of course.
I'm not really into it yet, but that doesn't mean I'll break my promise.
Like I said before, Jimin, deep down, we're not as selfish at all, you know? Sharing new things like this for other people, that's something that only really good people do.
Thanks, Sayori. I'm not sure if Sayori sees this full picture of my motive here. Then again, I can't deny that she's part of the reason I joined. Knowing how much this means to her and all.
Yeah. Now I'm gonna make sure you have lots of fun here, okay? That will be my way of thanking you.
Alright, I'm going to hold you to that then.
Yay! Now you'll read my poem too, right? Don't worry, I'm really bad at this.
We'll see about that.
Okay.
Alright. Dear sunshine, the way you glow through my blinds in the morning, it makes me feel like you miss me. Kiss my forehead to get and help me out of bed. Make me rub the sleep beam from my eyes. Are you asking me to come out and play? Are you trusting me to wish away a rainy day? I look above, the sky is blue. It's a secret, but I trust you too. If it wasn't for you, I could sleep forever. But I'm not mad. I want breakfast. Sayori, this is just a guess, but did you wait until this morning to write this?
No! Just a little bit.
You can't answer just a little bit to a yes or no question.
I forgot to do it last night.
Well, at least that makes me feel a little better about myself.
Don't be mean. I still tried my best.
Oh, yeah. I didn't mean to say that it was a bad poem. It came out nice, or how should I put it? It sounds just like you.
Really?
Yeah. Especially the last line.
I made eggs and toast.
Even though you were late to school?
It's bad to skip breakfast. I get all cranky.
Well, I guess there's no point in arguing. Anyway, thanks for showing me.
This was so much fun. Monica's the best.
Yeah.
But next time I won't forget. And I'm gonna make the best poem ever.
Well, I guess I look forward to it. Alright, I'm gonna look at Yuri's poem next. Yuri stares at the poem. A minute passes, more than enough time for her to finish reading. Sorry. I forgot to start speaking. It's fine. Don't force yourself. I'm not. I just need to put my thoughts into words. Hold on. Okay. This is your first time writing a poem, right?
Yeah. Why do you ask?
I'm just making sure. I guess that it might be after reading through it.
So it's that bad.
No! Did I just raise my voice? I'm so sorry.
Yuri buries her face in her hands. I couldn't help but notice that it's been several minutes and we really haven't gotten anywhere.
It might take Yuri a while to get used to new people.
It's fine, I really didn't notice.
What were you saying? Right, it's just that there are specific writing habits that are usually typical of new writers. And having been through that myself, I kind of learned to pick up on them. I think the most noticeable thing I recognize in new writers is that they try to make their style very deliberate. In other words, they tend to pick a writing style separate from the topic matter, and they form fit the two together. The end result is that both the style and the expressiveness are weakened. Once Yuri finds her train of thought, it's as if her demeanor totally changes. Her stammering is completely gone, and she sounds like an expert. Of course, that's not something you can be blamed for. There are so many different skills and techniques that go into writing, even a simple poem. Not just finding them and building them, but getting them to work together is probably the most challenging part. It might take you some time, but it all comes with practice and learning by example and trying new things. I also hope that everyone else in the club gives you valuable feedback. Natsuki can be a little bit biased, though.
Biased? How?
Well,
Never mind. I shouldn't be talking about people like that. Sorry.
It's fine. I'm not sure if Yuri is apologizing to herself, to me, or to Natsuki. Do you mind if I read your poem now?
Please do. I'd love to share my thought process behind it.
Yuri smiles dreamily as if the rare opportunity for her, which itself is kind of funny. After all, isn't this supposed to be a literature club? Alright. Ghost under the light. The tendrils of my hair illuminate beneath the amber glow, bathing. It must be this one. The last remaining streetlight to have withstood the test of time. The last yet to be replaced by the sickening blue-green hue of the future. I bathe, calm, breathing air of the present but living in the past. The light flickers, I flicker back.
Whoa.
I'm sorry I have such terrible handwriting.
What?
I wasn't thinking that at all. But it took you a long time to read.
Well, I just don't read scripts very often.
I actually think your handwriting is pretty.
Eh?
That's a relief. Also, I like the poem. Even though it's short, it was really descriptive. It wasn't too short. I usually write longer poems. Not at all. I'm really glad you liked it. I'll be honest, since it's our first time sharing, I wanted to write something a little more mild. Something easy to digest, I suppose.
Are you in a ghost, Yuri?
Actually, the story isn't about a ghost at all, Jimin.
Really? I must have totally missed the point.
Well, I suppose you did only glance over it after all. But remember that poets often express their own thoughts, feelings, and experiences in their work. They usually do more than tell a simple story or paint a picture. In this case, perhaps the subject of the poem is only being symbolically compared to a ghost. Lingering in her last remaining place of comfort, unable to let go of the past, and soon to be left with nothing.
That's a lot more solemn, putting it that way.
I hadn't even thought of that.
That's impressive.
It's nothing, really. Well, it makes me happy that you think that. Just remember that it won't be long before you pick up on these things, too.
Yeah, maybe you're right. I guess I'll have to keep trying.
I'm counting on you.
Alright, now it's Natsuki's turn.
Well, it's about what I expected from someone like you.
That's a little blunt.
Well, excuse me. It's not like I said it was bad. It's just even evoked any emotions.
So basically, it's not cute enough for your taste?
Do you want to get smacked?
I'll pass.
Well, anyway, I guess I need to show you mine. Now that you'll like it.
Eagles can fly. Megas can climb. Crickets can leap. Horses can race, owls can seek, cheetahs can run, eagles can fly, people can try, but that's about it.
Yeah, I told you that you weren't gonna like it.
I like it.
What? Just be honest!
I am. Why are you so convinced that I wouldn't like it?
Well, because everyone in high school thinks that writing has to be all sophisticated and stuff. So people don't even take my writing seriously.
Isn't the point of poems for people to express themselves? Your writing style wouldn't make your message any less valid.
Yes, exactly! I like when it's easy to read, but it hits you hard. Like in this poem. Seeing everyone around you do great things can be really disheartening. So I decided to write about it.
Yes, oh my god. That poem actually makes sense.
Yeah, I understand. But
But the other nice thing about simple rhyming is that it puts more weight on the wordplay. Like I said, it for a rhyme at the end, but then made it fall flat on purpose. It helps bring out the feeling in the last line.
So you did.
I guess more went into it than I realized.
That's what it means to be a pro! I'm glad you learned something. Didn't expect that from the youngest one here, did you?
Yeah, I guess not. I decided to humor her with that last comment. I don't really care about how old everyone is, but if Nazuki is feeling proud, then I won't take that away from her. The only one left is Monica, I guess.
Hi, Jimin. Having a good time so far?
Yeah.
Good, glad to hear it. By the way, since you're new and everything, if you ever have any suggestions for the club, like new activities or things we can do better, I'm always listening. Don't be afraid to bring things up, okay?
Alright, I'll keep that in mind. Of course I'll be afraid to bring things up. I'm much better off just going off with the flow until I'm more settled in.
Anyway, wanna share your poem with me?
It's kind of embarrassing, but I guess I have to.
Don't worry, Jimin. We're all a little embarrassed today, you know? But it's that sort of barrier that we'll all learn to get past soon.
Yeah, that's true. I hand Monica my poem.
Mm-hmm. I like this one. It makes me think of something Sayori would like.
Is that so? You and Sayori are really good friends, right?
I wouldn't be surprised if,
well. Crap, I just skipped that line. We may be good friends, but Sayori and I are actually really different.
Well, that may be the case. But maybe there are also some similarities I wouldn't expect. The way she talks about you, it sounds like the two of you really care about each other's well-being. Even if you show it in different ways, it ends up being more similar than you think. So I think that's the kind of vibe I get when reading your poem.
Mm-hmm. You sure you're not reading into it too much?
I could be. Oh gosh, I sound like Yuri. But in any case, Yuri's writing has kind of a gentle feel to it. I can tell what she likes exploring with her emotions, like happiness and sadness. Who knew that someone so happy would enjoy sad things too?
Yeah, that's totally unexpected.
Well, to each their own. And you shouldn't be afraid to experiment a little either.
I'm sure I'll end up trying different things a lot. It could take a while before I feel comfortable doing this.
That's okay. I love to see you try new things. That's the best way to find the kind of style that suits you. Everyone else might be a little bit biased towards their own kind of styles, but I'll always help you find what suits you the most. So don't force yourself to write the way everyone else wants you to write. It's not like you have to worry about impressing them or anything. Anyway, do you want to read my poem now? Don't worry, I'm not very good.
You sound pretty confident for someone who claims to not be very good.
Well, that's because I have to sound confident. It doesn't mean I always feel that way, you know?
I see. Well, let's read it then. Hole in the wall. It couldn't have been me. See, the direction the spackle protrudes, a noisy neighbor, an angry boyfriend, I'll never know I wasn't home. I peer inside for a clue. No, I can't see. I reel, blind like a film left out in the sun. But it's too late. My retinas. I already scorched with a permanent copy of a meaningless image. It's just a little hole. It wasn't too bright. It was too deep, stretching forever into everything. A hole of infinite choices. I realize now that I wasn't looking in. I was looking out. And he, on the other side, was looking in.
What? So, what do you think?
It's very
free form, if that's what you call it. Sorry, I'm not really the right person to ask for feedback. It's okay. That kind of style has gotten pretty popular nowadays. That is, a lot of poems have to be putting emphasis on the timing between words and lines. When performed out loud, it can be really powerful. What was the inspiration behind this one? I'm not sure if I know how to put it. I guess you could say that I had some kind of epiphany recently. It's been influencing my poems a bit.
An epiphany?
Yeah, something like that. I'm kind of nervous to talk about deep stuff like that because it's kind of coming on strongly. Maybe after everyone is better friends with each other. Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Sometimes when you're writing a poem or a story, your brain gets too fixated on a specific point. If you try so hard to make it perfect, you'll never make any progress. Just force yourself to get something down on the paper and tidy it up later. Another way to think about it is this. If you keep your pen in the same spot for too long, you'll just get a dark, big puddle of ink. So just move your hand and go with the flow. That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening.
Whew. Okay, I'm going to leave this episode here. Dang, this episode was really nice. I'm going to keep going on trying to get to Sayori to like me still. Because right now, she seems to be a very interesting person. So, right now, thank you all so much for watching this episode of Doki Doki Literature Club. Nothing has really happened so far. Well, that's good. So, in the meantime, thank you all so much for watching. As always, if you guys did enjoy this episode, why not be a awesome person by high-fiving the like button? I'll see all of you awesome people in the next video.